Hello everybody. Today we are going to discuss the system peripherals for ARM7. They are primarily based on LPC2100 series given by Philips. So when we talk about system peripherals, they refer to all the devices which are used in conjunction with the core for the system to work properly. As a for a functioning of a complete task. Okay, so let's start with this. When I talk about system peripherals in ARM7, they primarily refer to bus structure, memory map, memory accelerator module, phase lock loop, UART, and a watchdog timer. But in this presentation, we are going to talk about memory accelerator module. So let's understand the need before we go into the details of what is a memory accelerator module. When we talk about performance of an ARM, we normally refer to the speed of the processor. We try to increase the speed of the processor, but we have to understand this, that just like in the pipelining we saw, the memory access time is also a prime limitation to the performance of the system, because it is going to get data or the code from the memory. So till our memory is working fast, our processing speed cannot be exploited to its maximum, you can say, level. For example, we have an ARM CPU which is running at 80 megahertz. And it is using flash. Flash, you know, it is a fast memory. It is a parallel memory which has access time of 50 nanoseconds. Okay. But if I see the speed, to see the speed of the frequency, if I divide it 1 over 50, I get typically the speed of 20 megahertz. So fastest what I can get is 20 megahertz. So though my processor, it is able to process at the speed of 80 megahertz, it is limited by memory access to just 20 megahertz. So this is a big barrier to exploitation of the maximum processing speed of a processor. So how to come about this problem? There are a number of solutions, but the easiest which we can think of is use of RAM. We all know that RAM is a fast memory, and RAM has the access time of typically around 10 to 20 nanoseconds, which is pretty faster than flash. Okay, but at the same time, it is costly. So it is a precious resource which we cannot afford to fill in with all the application instructions. So this is giving me a limited solution. Coming to the next one, other solution is use of on-chip cache. Cache, I know it is on-chip memory, just in the direct communication with the processor. So it is having fastest access, it is limited in capacity, and normally used to store the instructions which have the recent access or which are repeated over the time. Okay, so it is, since processor can directly communicate with the cache, it is thought to be quite faster as compared to other memories which are existing in the system. But again, if I increase the size of the cache, it is going to add into my chip area as well as cost of the system. So again, this is not a feasible solution. So what then? The solution here comes in the form of memory accelerator module, which compromises between the complexity of a full cache and the simplicity of the simple flash access or the simple memory access. How does it play? This is the structure in which it works. So basically, memory accelerator module, it is sitting between the processor and between the flash memory, and it connects to the local bus to the CPU. So again, the limitation of the bus speed is going to be there. So how does it help in faster access. So, to provide the faster access, our memory is actually, flash memory is divided into two different equal banks or equal units. Let's say if I have 64K of memory, I will divide it into two units of 32K each. Okay? And these are interleaved. When I say interleaved, it means that if my first address 00H is in the bank 0 on the first unit, my memory location 001 would be in the second bank or the second unit. So that is what interleaved structure is going to be. So the sequence it is zigzag of the memories which are placed, sequential addresses of the memory. And the width of the word size and the width of this, each location of this interleaved bank is 128 bits. These 128 bits, the word 128, if I divide 128 by 32, what do I get? Just check and see, it should come out to be 4. So it, and I know each instruction of ARM is 32 bit wide. So it means those 128 bits which comprise one word of the bank of flash memory, they are containing 4 ARM instructions or equivalently 8 thumb instructions, because thumb instruction size is 16 bits. Okay? Now what is the advantage of this arrangement? I'll like to jump to the next slide for this. So this is what happens. So I store my first instruction in bank 0, which is my first bank, and next 4 instructions in the other bank. Okay, so what is the advantage? Both of these banks, they will be connected by independent address buses which will be communicating with the memory access, a memory accelerator module. And this memory accelerator module in turn would be connected to processor or ARM7 CPU through local bus. So whenever I have to access the first 4 instructions, they would be independently brought in the flash memory and fill in the memories from 000H in bank 0 to 0003. So 4 memory locations they would be filled. Now while these are executing, my next 4 instructions of the program, they would be prefetched by the address bus of bank 1 and they would be kept ready for execution. So this way I don't have to wait for my buses to first complete the execution and then fetch the instruction from the next address. Okay, and memory accelerator module is providing these fetched instructions to the processor. I hope it is clear. So typically for our ARM7, this is the diagram. So I have 2 banks. So there is an address which is being loaded and accordingly they are being accessed from each bus bank. And the next 4-bit address which has to be accessed is given to the MAM, which is actually communicating it to the bank where it is relevant to. And memory accelerator module is then passing on the data which is fetched to the processor. Now for a configuration of, for working of this memory accelerator module, we need to have certain registers, that is timing register and a configuration register. Timing register is nothing but it controls the timing between the clock and the flash access. For example, we were talking about that our processor speed is 80 MHz and our flash access time is 50 nanoseconds, giving me the maximum speed of 20 MHz. So 20 into 4 will give me 80. So I will have to fill in 4 as number of flash cycles required to fill in 1 clock cycle of the processor. Okay, so that is being controlled by the timing register. Configuration we will just see after some time. Before that, we have to understand what is configuration. Configuration, when I say, it means what? I have to configure my system as to how it is going to work. So memory accelerator module also needs to be configured, because it gives me the flexibility how I want to work with my system. It can work in disable mode, that is when my memory accelerator mode is not in action. It is just simply working as direct communication between my processor and flash memory. That is this first figure. Okay. Next is partially enabled. Partially enabled, what we do is whatever is in the sequence, that is which is stored sequentially. If I have set of, let's say, 10 instructions and they are in sequence one after the other, okay, they are fed to ARM through MAM, that is memory accelerator module. But if there is any loop or any branch, that is where I have to go to a different address, then we make use of the direct mode of acting between ARM and flash. So there is no MAM used there. And the last mode is fully enabled mode. In case of that, all my data and code, including the branches, loops, they are accessing the memory through MAM only. Okay. So we have already discussed about the three modes: disabled, partially enabled, and fully enabled. Obviously, partially enabled and fully enabled, they give me the better speed and better performance as compared to the disabled mode. But partially or fully, I cannot always say that fully is going to give me the best performance. That depends how many loops and branches you have. If we have more number of loops and branches, though we do have buffers in this for looping, for small loops or the loops which are there, but still, if too many loops and branches are there, use of MAM may provide a limitation, because it is again going to go to a different address, pick up more instructions, then come to another set of addresses which is different, which is out of sequence. Okay, so it may not give me that work that efficiently. So in that case, we can use partially enabled. Okay, next, coming to the statistics register frame here. Statistics registers, they are based on the counters which record the number of accesses which are made to flash or to the MAM. The prime reason for that is to calculate how much efficiency we have achieved using this MAM. So lesser are the accesses to the flash by the processor directly, more your efficiency, more is the efficiency and the performance of your system. Further, the accesses can be refined as to if they are coming from the buffer or they are coming from the flash directly. So this is all about memory access accelerator module. I hope it is very clear to you. Thank you so much.